please? How are you? This is Assistant Professor Kailesh Muridhar Jadhav, and I welcome you all for this lecture, which is for BCCS Seminar Financial Accounting students. And this, in this lecture, we will going to discuss how to make journal entries. From previous lectures, we are doing same thing, but in each and every lecture, we are studying one at least one entry which is new in each and every lecture. So in this lecture also we will going to discuss lots of entries. Mainly we will going to discuss 10 major entries in our video. In previous lecture we have seen lots of entries in which we have dealt with lots of entries, but in this lecture you will going to study a entry where you can see where something is different from previous entries. So let us begin with our lecture. So before starting lecture, I want to praise you that I have given homework to you and you have given overwhelming response to this that, and that is good, and that thing is good in you that you are submitting your homework. But still some students are left with their work, so please I kindly request them to submit their homework as soon as possible so that I can hand in that homework to you as soon as possible. So let us start with our lecture. So in our lecture we have Mr. Charlie Chaplin. Okay, he has a shop and he has done various transactions. So we as a financial accountants, we are responsible for making journal entries in the books of Mr. Charlie Chaplin's shop, not in the book of Charlie Chaplin's personal book. Okay, we are going to deal with this transaction in the books of, in the business book of Charlie Chaplin and not in personal book of Charlie Chaplin. And let us have examples, let us have some transactions to study financial accounting and how to make journal entries. So in our first entry, you can see that Mr. CC, Mr. CC means Charlie Chaplin. Mr. Charlie Chaplin given rupees 6,000 to business. Given 6,000 to whom? To business. That means cash is coming into the business. Cash flow is coming in. Cash is coming in. That's why we have to debit cash. On date 1, we have it here different types of date, so we are considering serial number as date. So our first transaction is Mr. CC given 60,000 to business. That means there are again two aspects. First one is cash, another one is capital. So capital means the account of business owner, that means Mr. CC. This too we have learnt in previous lecture so many times, but for the sake of revision, I am putting very much emphasis on these types of entries so that you will not going to forget these types of entries in your life. So first we have cash account, cash, the another one is capital. So cash is coming, that means it will be debited, and Mr. C, nothing but capital account. So Mr. C is receiver or giver, he is giver of money. So he is giver, giver means Mr. C, that means capital account. Mr. C means capital account, nothing but capital account. That means he, that person will be, because he is giver, capital account will be credited. So our entry will be cash account debit to capital account, to capital account, and amount will be 60,000. Amount will be 60,000 rupees. You have to follow proper pro forma while making journal entries. And if you haven't submitted your homeworks yet, so you should consider the format in this shape only, in this format only. You have to put first column as date, next one particular, then after LF, debit amount and credit amount. And we have done with our first entry, and narration will be being business owner provided cash to the business, nothing else. Okay, I am closing this. Okay. You have to write your narration by your own, because we have not ample amount of time, so that I can write all types of narration in each and every journal entries. So you have to consider narration as your part, and you can make narration very easily. But you have to think what is happening in particular transaction. Then only you will be able to make narrations. So please give your consideration to provide narrations. If you are not providing so your marks can be deducted. So we have done with our first entry. Okay, coming to the second one, cash deposited in SBI account, ₹5,000. So this business of Mr. Charlie Chaplin they have business account in SBI. So in SBI's account, this business has current account. So this SBI account, we have two aspects again here. First one is cash. Cash deposited means first aspect is cash, and another one will be SBI account. So cash is real account and cash is going out or coming in. So we have to consider transaction very deeply. So we are depositing money, that means bank will receive money from us, that means we will be the giver of money, and cash will go out, that means cash will go out means cash is real account and debit what comes in and credit what goes out. So cash is going out here, that's why cash will be credited. You can repeat golden rules with my words as I am repeating again and again. So let's do that for SBI account. So SBI is this is not nominal account and not the real account. Why? Because nominal account says expenses and losses, income and gains, and real account says assets. So both will not be considered for SBI account. So one and only remain is SBI account is personal account. So personal account, that means person's account, and we have three types of person: natural, representative and artificial. So this is artificial personal account, and artificial personal account means this is a person which has entity but not has physical existence. So dear friends, this is a person, and this person, this artificial person, is receiving money from us. So this is none other than SBI is receiver of money. So person, receiver, that means SBI is person, and that person is receiver. So personal account says debit the receiver, credit the giver. So you can think SBI can be credited or debited. Obviously it will be debited. So we will be writing entry here like SBI account will be debited. SBI's account will be debited to cash account, and amount will be, my friends, this will be 5000. Okay, and narration will be being cash deposited. We have completed two entries, now we are on the third entry. This is the entry at which you have to think for a while. Why? Because this entry is not explained in previous lectures. So this is the USP of this entry. So what the meaning of this entry? So let us have a look on our transaction, what our transaction is saying. Purchase goods of ₹50,000. This is too common, purchasing of goods, very common. But what is the new thing? New thing is this is from Mr. X on credit for 30,000 and remain amount in cash. In previous lecture we have seen purchase things maybe on credit or maybe on cash, but this is the combined transaction in which we have purchased goods in which we have paid immediately something and some part of amount is on credit basis. That means this transaction is partly on credit and partly on cash basis. So we have to track what are the aspects involved in this transaction. To get the aspects involved in this transaction, you have to read it properly. You have to catch different types of accounts properly. So what are the different types or what are the different types of action in this transaction is, first of all, first will be purchase account. Purchase goods with purchase account. The other part, Mr. X. Other one, it is cash. Okay, so we'll be having 1, 2, and 3 aspects. I'm writing here aspects to make journal entry very clear. So first is purchase account, and another one is cash account, and the last one is Mr. X account. So purchase goods, that means at what amount we have purchase goods? At 50,000. At 50,000 we have purchase goods. And cash, we have to wait for cash. First we will going to discuss about Mr. X. Mr. X has supplied goods. That one is supplier for us, and that person has supplied goods for rupees 50,000, at which here in transaction only there is written Mr. X on credit for 30,000. So we have purchased goods of 50,000, in which 30,000 is on credit basis, and remaining amount means 50,000 minus 30,000. 50,000 minus 30,000 is 20,000, and that 20,000 will be our cash treatment. So 20,000 will be cash, and 30,000 will be credit, and credit amount will be written in the front of Mr. X account, because that person is giver of that supplies, given of that goods. So we have three things in which purchase account is nominal account and debit on expenses and losses. That's why purchase account will be debited, and cash is going out or coming in. First of all, cash, we are purchasing something, that means we have to pay to someone. That means cash will be debited. No, that will be credited. Cash will be credited with rupees 20,000. Why? Because cash is going out. And last one, Mr. X. Mr. X means personal account. Personal account says debit the receiver, credit the giver. And Mr. X here is receiver or giver. That person is receiver of money, but giver of goods. So this person is giver. Okay, giver means credit. So this person will be credited. So how we can plot this entry in our format? You can write here like this: purchase account debited with rupees 50,000, and two things which we can credit. And first one is cash account. Cash account will be credited with rupees 20,000, and remaining part, that means to Mr. X account will be credited with rupees 30,000. If you haven't understood this entry, you can take pause and you can rewind the video to get this thing in your mind at proper basis. So what can be the narration for this entry? Narration will be this entry narration is somewhat difficult, so I am telling you can write with my pace. Purchase goods from Mr. X, in which 30,000 is on credit basis and 20,000 is on cash basis. This is how you can narrate lines here. So coming to the fourth one is again somewhat critical. You have to think this very seriously. So put your focus here. Okay, electricity expenses accrued rupees 8,000. Accrued means that expense has arisen but haven't yet paid. That means we have taken, we have studied, there are three types of transaction. First, that might be in advance. Second one, that can be on exactly on the date at which it has arrived, and that means on actual basis. And third one is on outstanding basis. Outstanding basis means we haven't paid it. The accurate meaning of outstanding in Hindi is bakaya. That means it is remaining to pay. It hasn't paid. We haven't paid yet. That means that amount is not recorded yet. So what we can do? We have to record because it has accrued. So it has accrued. So what can be the entry? Again, we have to think what are the aspects involved in this transaction. So what are the aspects involved in this transaction? So if you read, we can see there is only one electricity expenses. But if you will think, there are two. First, electricity bill, electricity expenses. We should say electricity expenses. And another will be that means accrued na. Accrued means outstanding. So outstanding expenses. The logic of outstanding expenses and advance expenses I have given you in previous lectures. So for detailed info, you have to get through from the previous lectures. So to get entry, what we can write here, this is expense, that means nominal account. Nominal account says debit or expenses. So this will be debited. And the other part of this, this is the representative personal account. This is representing some person. So person, that means if we will going to pay something, so that person will be receiver or giver. Definitely that person will receiver of money, but that person hasn't yet received money. So to arise that entry in our book, we have to debit that person. If we will going to credit that person, we have to credit that person. If we will going to debit in that person in next or in nearer future. So to arise that person's entry, we have to credit that person. If we want to debit that person in nearer future, so this will be debited at outstanding expenses personal account. And here something is on credit basis, not on cash basis, so this account will be credited. So what is how we can plot this entry? We can plot this entry like this. Electricity expenses account debited, and amount will be 8000 to outstanding electricity expenses account. That will be 8000, and this will be your liability. Okay, that means you have to pay this expense in near future. Okay, you haven't paid yet, but you have to pay for this. So we have completed the fourth one. Now we are focusing our view on fifth one. And what is fifth saying? Rent paid in advance, rupees 3000. Again, we will be having two aspects. First is rent, and another one will be advance. And first one is rent, and we will be providing this amount to some person, to someone. For example, I am putting here Mr. E. Okay, we will be going to provide income to rent to Mr. E in advance. So we are paying something to someone, but in advance. That means expenses haven't made yet, but we are paying. So if rent hasn't accrued, so we cannot debit or credit any expenses and losses unless it hasn't accrued. So rent will not be debited or credited in this case. So what can be debited or credited? And that account is cash account. Why cash account? We are paying in advance. Paid means cash will be going out, and cash will be going out means cash account will be credited. Why? Because cash will be credited. Why? Because cash is going out, and real accounts rule says debit what comes in, credit what goes out. That's why cash account will be credited. And Mr. E is receiver of money. Mr. E is receiver of money. That's why Mr. E's account will be debited. But new thing in this lecture is Mr. E will not be debited or credited, because we have rule of representative personal account, where it says you have to debit or credit things at outstanding basis or prepaid basis without their name. So this person's name will not be in our book. We will going to put here the prepaid rent account. And prepaid rent account is representation of Mr. E. This account is nothing but Mr. E's account. That's why prepaid rent account will be debited. So how we can plot that? Prepaid rent account will be debited with rupees, put your concentration here, with rupees 3000, and cash will be credited, cash account will be credited with rupees 3000. This is how you can put this entries. So if you want to discuss in detail these entries, if you have any doubt in these entries, you can put text to me to take extra lectures on these concepts. So how you can write this entry, so that I have told you in this. So how you can approach to this entry, that you can see in this lecture. If you haven't cleared with this, if you are not satisfied with this explanation, so what you can do, you can put text to me that sir, we haven't clear with this, you can take more lectures on this concept, so I can give this favor for you. So coming to the sixth entry, what sixth entry is saying? Income received in advance. So again we have two aspects. First one is income. So income received. So first one is income. In advance, we have paid something. That means we have paid cash. So we have again first cash. We are paying cash or receiving cash. Income received. That means we will going to receive cash. That means cash will be coming in. And another part will be income. But again, exact like in this transaction, we will not going to debit or credit this account. Why? Because income hasn't accrued yet. What I said? Income hasn't accrued yet, and we have received that income. So we will not going to debit or credit income, but the account of pre-receive income. Exactly like this account only. So we will going to write here pre-receive income account. So that is how you can put these things on your working note to get journal entries. So cash is coming in, so cash will be debited. Why? I will not going to tell you, because I have told you lots of times, so you have to read and go through with previous lectures, so you can get why I have credited or debited anything. So I am debiting about cash here. You have to think, you have to put your logic to get this concept. And pre-receive income. So again we will going to think about this concept. So if pre-receive income, that means we are receiving income from someone. So let us say we are receiving income from Mr. D. So this Mr. D is receiver or giver? Mr. D is giver here, my friends. why Mr. D is receiver or giver, why Mr. D is giver here? Because Mr. D is providing cash to us, that person providing income to us, that's why Mr. D account will be credited. Why credited? Because debit the receiver, credit the giver. So Mr. D's account will be credited. So pre-receive income account is nothing but Mr. D's account. Okay, so we will not going to consider Mr. D's account. Instead of Mr. D's account, we will going to put pre-receive income account. So pre-receive income account will be credited with rupees 4000. That is how you can write your entries. You can apply logic to the to these types of entries. So what, how we can write here? We will going to write here like cash, we are receiving cash, that's why cash account will be debited. And to pre receive income account, and amount will be 4000. Okay, put your concentration here, don't jumble your mind and do not get distracted with any other thing. You have to put your concentration on whiteboard only. Okay, we have completed 6 entries. We have again 4 entries in our pocket. So the 7th entry is commission accrued but not received. Same case like this only. So commission has accrued but we haven't received. So if something has haven't accrued and we are debiting that thing or crediting that thing, that is not allowable. So if that thing is has accrued, so we have to consider that account. So what transaction 7 is saying, commission has accrued but we haven't received commission yet. You have to analyze the transaction. We have not received but accrued. So we have to consider commission because it has accrued. Commission account, commission, and another one will be we have received something, that means we have received cash. So we have received cash. Have we received cash? Think transaction properly. We have commission accrued but not received. That means cash will not be in the case. Okay, again we are going to try get more aspect involved in this transaction. We have considered commission, we have considered cash, and next one is accrual. And accrued things, that means something which is on credit basis and not on cash basis. So we have not received but someone will going to give commission to us. So let's say Mr. C is providing commission. Okay, so commission is my income. So commission is my income, that's why commission will be credited. So commission will be credited. And the another part of this transaction is Mr. C. So Mr. C is here representative of outstanding income account, outstanding income or outstanding commission account, outstanding commission account. So Mr. C is receiver or giver, that person is giver, that's why that must be credited. But we haven't received that amount. If we are going to receive, we have to debit that amount. We have to debit Mr. C. But we haven't received amount, and in near future we have to debit it. That's why we are debiting Mr. C. Mr. C's account will be debited, and we will not going to write Mr. C's account. We will going to write outstanding commission account instead of writing Mr. C's account. So we will not going to use Mr. C's account, we will going to use name of commission account. So commission account will be debited, commission account will be credited, but outstanding commission will be debited. So I'm writing here. Seventh one. What is the debiting amount? Debiting amount is from commission outstanding commission account debited with ₹2,000 to commission account. To commission account. This is how you can write. You can plot your entries here. We don't have LF info, so we are not writing LF info. LF means laser folio. So this is how you can plot seventh entry on your sheets. Now we are coming to eighth one. Cash withdrawn by Mr. CC for marriage of his son, ₹50,000. So Charlie Chaplin, Chaplin's son, is going to marry. So Charlie Chaplin is requiring cash. So Charlie Chaplin withdrawn some part of amount from his business. So what can be the entry? First of all, we should think this is not the transaction of business. This is the personal transaction of Mr. C. But what the part of business book can play here, that business from business book, that means our cash, that means business cash will go out. That's why we have to consider that account only. And we, no matter for which purpose Mr. C is using, but that should not be the business purpose. If he is using for business purpose, we have to consider that cash as business expense. But marriage of Charlie Chaplin, Chaplin's son is not the business expense. That one is personal expense. That's why we have to think what are the two accounts involved in this transaction. First of all, first is cash and the other one is Mr. C. So cash is coming in or going out. I have to write two things. First thing, Mr. CC, and another one is cash. So cash is going out or coming in. Mr. C is taken from business. Mr. C is taking from business. That means cash will go out. That's why cash will be credited. And what will be debited then? Mr. C. Mr. C is receiver or giver. If business is paying to someone, that means counterparty will receive amount. That means Mr. C will be debited. Why? Because Mr. C is receiver here. But instead of using Mr. C's account, we will going to use capital account. And if we are debiting capital, that means we have to credit drawing account. Okay. So instead of writing Mr. C's account, we are going to write drawings account, and this is under the head of capital account. But in this transaction, we will going to use it as drawing account and cash account. So Mr. C is nothing but drawing account. So drawing account will be debited. So drawing account will be debited with ₹50,000 to cash account. Okay, and how you can write narration for this? Being cash withdrawn by business owner. We have completed 9th one, and again we have completed 8th one, and now we are on 9th. And what is 9th one saying? Sold goods at ₹1 lakh. Okay, no new thing, this is common one, that we have sold goods for ₹1 lakh. What is new then? In which ₹40,000 received immediately in cash. What is transaction is saying? We have received 40,000 in cash immediately and 60,000 by check. Total transaction amount is 1 lakh. We have received cash for 40,000 and check for 60,000. So again we can plot our accounts here. So what are the accounts involved in this? First of all, sold means sales account. Okay. After that, 40k is cash and 60k is check. Check means bank account. So we have sales account for 1 lakh, sales account for 1 lakh, cash is for 40,000, and check means bank account. So bank account is for 60k. So which amount can be debited, which account can be credited, we can consider here by putting our golden rules of accounting, putting our logic. So sales is my income, that's why that should be credited. Why? Because nominal account says debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gains. So that's why sales account will be credited, and cash is coming in or going out. Cash is coming in, why? Because we are selling something, that's why we are selling something. That means we have to receive cash for that transaction. So cash account is real account, and debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So cash is received, going out or coming in. We can see here cash is coming in because it is sales. So cash account will be debited, and bank is receiver or giver here, my friends. Bank is receiver of money. From our part, bank will receive money. Bank will receive 60,000 from particular check. So bank is receiver, that's why debit the receiver, credit the giver. So that's why bank account will be debited. So how we can write that entry here? Ninth one, first of all, cash account will be debited with rupees 40,000. Why? We can read from this. Rupees 40,000 received immediately in cash. That's why cash account will be debited with rupees 40,000. And by check, rupees 60,000. Check means bank account. So bank account will be debited with rupees 60,000. And lastly, sales account with rupees 1 lakh. Put it in your mind. If there is combined entry, you have to think, you have to read that transaction twice. If you are not doing so that will be problematic for you. And don't show your over smartness in your studies. Okay, if you will going to show your over smartness here, you're not going to read anything new, and you can let go so many things, you can let go your knowledge. So that's why that will be very much difficult for you, and you have to put your consideration here. Okay, last entry. But before going to discuss last entry, I am going to tell you what will be the narration for this entry. And narration for this entry will be, being sold goods at rupees 1 lakh, in which 40,000 received in cash and 60,000 via check. So we have completed 9th one, now we are on 10th one. And what is 10th entry saying? Paid cash to Mr. X. Paid cash to Mr. X rupees 29,000 in full settlement. So first of all, you think to whom we are paying, and you will find answer to Mr. X. So who is Mr. X? Is Mr. X friend to us, that we are providing cash to Mr. X as help? No. This is the person from which we have purchased goods. You can put your concentration on transaction number 3, in which you can find Mr. X as your supplier, as your creditor for business. So we have to pay to Mr. X. Why? Because we have purchased something from Mr. X. So this is one line statement which is looking like very simple thing, but that will create headache for you if you are not going to consider that entry as important one. If you are not putting your concentration here, you are not going to get amounts, you are not going to get entries in this transaction. So again, we will going to plot different types of accounts involved here. So first of all, we will going to write here Mr. X is involved here. We are paying cash. Paid cash means we are paying something. Paying cash. So cash will be the next one. Okay. तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू थिंक व्हाट इज द अमाउंट पेबल टू मिस्टर एक्स. सो यू विल फाइंड दैट वी हैव परचेज गुड्स फ्रॉम मिस्टर एक्स 50,000. वी हैव परचेज गुड्स ऑफ 50,000 फ्रॉम मिस्टर एक्स एंड 30,000 वॉज इन क्रेडिट एंड 20,000 वॉज ऑन कैश. सो वी हैव टू थिंक ओनली फॉर कैश. वी हैव टू थिंक ओनली फॉर 30,000. तो वी आर लाइबल टू पे टू मिस्टर एक्स रुपीज 30,000. टू वी हैव टू पुट हियर 30,000. एंड हाउ मच अमाउंट वी आर पेइंग टू मिस्टर एक्स? वी आर पेइंग 29,000. सो वी हैव टू राइट हियर 20,000. सॉरी नॉट 20,000, माय बैड, दिस इज माय मिस्टेक. दिस इज नॉट 20,000, दिस इज 29,000. ओके, एंड व्हाट विल बी द रिमेनिंग अमाउंट? देन व्हाट विल बी द ट्रीटमेंट फॉर 1,000? And the treatment can be understand as discount. Why? If you have purchased goods for 30,000 from someone and you are paying 29,000 instead of 30,000, and you are not providing 1,000 to that person, and you said this is the full settlement. This is the full settlement means we will not going to pay you a single penny in nearer future for this transaction. That means for 30,000 in full settlement we will going to pay 29 only, and 1,000 will be taken as our benefit, and we will going to name that benefit as discount received account. Haven't we received income indirectly here? Definitely we have received indirectly discount here. So this part of this this 1,000 will be transferred to discount received account. Okay, let's plot it. So Mr. X is receiver of money. That's why Mr. X account will be debited with rupees 30,000. We have paid cash, that means we have to credit cash account with rupees 29,000. And discount received, that means, is this a person? No. So personal account will not apply here. Is this asset for me? No. So real accounts will not be working here. So the last one is remain, and that one is nominal account. And nominal account says debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gains. So this one is gain for me. So that's why I am going to credit discount received account with rupees 1,000. And that is how I can plot this entry for transaction number 10. So we have completed 10th as well. If you have any doubt in this entry, you can ask me out at by giving me text or putting mail to me, or you can direct call. If you are finding this transaction very hard, so you can ask me to take some another lectures to consider these types of transaction and only. So your response for homework was too good, but what I want to tell you that you have to put your courage to solve different types of transaction for journal entries, which I will going to provide you as practical question in nearer days. So stay tuned to our channel to get more knowledge, and till then be happy and get hungry for knowledge. Thank you.